Good boy!
Ed, your dog really did fabulous. He's a young dog, and he did a really good job.
Well, it's interesting to watch him work somebody that knows what he's doing, because we don't have good helpers. I mean, I can do this helper work, but you can't do it on your own dog. And it's kind of neat to watch him get a little bit of respect for somebody, because when we work him, he has no respect for anybody, and he's dirty. And it's kind of neat, you know, to see him back off and say, hey, maybe I'm not the toughest guy in the world.
Look at that intensity. He's very intense, though.
Stop! Bend him! Stop! Riviere!
Yeah. Jesus, that was good. He remembers that snap.
You get a guy, you get these dogs working on a guy like Kevin, they don't forget. Your dogs will be the star. See? Well, I'll be surprised now with my dog if he's much dirty at all during the whole thing.
Biting dog, if you ever take a hit off him, with a hidden sleeve, he's got...
Stand still!
What are they,
don't move! Let!
He's got like a 450, a 750, and then he goes at 110%. Yeah, he's got a 900 in there. It'll hurt him.
Stand still! Don't move! Let! Let! Thank you. Don't let him crawl. No crawling. All right, pick him up. I'm gonna fire him up when we leave. You put him up in your car.
That up, boy. There he goes. All right, good boy. Here.
A lot of praise. Tell him how good he is.
Get him. Yes, get him. Good pucket. Ah, good baby. Good boy. Sots a blob, yes.
Pick it up.
Sots a blob.
Peel him off. Take him off the leash. Video this. Right here where the dog is standing.
What?
I want to get that on video. That's all.
Pocket. Good. Good.
go.
Tuesday was the first time we did this with it.
But yeah, he's doing really, really good. But he looks right, he looks left. He doesn't want the
game. Put him up, Ben. He goes to the door, he stands in the middle of the door.
Running, or should I get
send
the
door?
Premier!
Well, I changed my mind.
Good feel boy! Good boy!
Feel him off.
Good boy!
Stay your body over here.
There you go. Good boy! Good boy! Let's go! Yeah, boy!
Take it back two steps and send it. Go back a few steps and send him.
Over here.
Straight up.
Step back. Hands up. Bad timing. I thought he,
Bad dog training.
I saw that. I saw it. After it was done, I saw it.
Do it again.
Don't worry. What can I say? We got it on video. We talked about it. Okay, house.
Let's do it right this time.
Stand still, house. Plats. 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 Step back.
You walk toward me in the middle.
Plats. On your leg?
That's
not on your leg.
Peel them off again.
Good. Perfect.
Good.
Good pocket.
Good.
Peel them off.
Revere!
fixed his dog. He hit him in the eye.
Oh, there, boy!
Heard it? That was the best thing that could have happened to him, boy.
Stay still! Don't move! Let's!
You are. Okay, you're going to see some shit I've seen that you ain't never seen before.
Let's!
On this hall.
Good.
That's what's great about coming.
Hey, I'm out of here. Oh, I'm sorry. Watch me when you're doing the work. Ready? Peel them off. Peel them off. Okay, put them on.
That a boy. Okay.
It was best for him to see how many times he said what. Dog on the plot's first time.
Fire him up.
Hustle.
Receives a bite. All right? Don't run up.
Okay.
You're biting your dog's attention at this point. We're going to extinguishing that later, but right now,
let's
Kevin, he may fight through your stick. He does with me. I can't clean him with a stick.
He's motivated.
You can't?
No. Okay. I'm sure you can, but I can't. Move with me.
discipline.
Does he have an out?
No, he's busted.
Yeah, out him.
Aus! Senior! Aus! Hey!
Fine boy, Cito. Oh, that boy, Cito. Heavier stick.
Is it the top or the bottom? Let him drag your long line, or drag the line.
Hey! Booing! 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 House! Let's! Let's! Cito, let's!
Step up to your dog.
Let's!
Whatever would be normal for you. Okay. I'm halfway to me. You can turn around. Make yourself to the dog and holler at him twice.
The good thing.
Put your hands up.
Here is he's going to learn how to
let.
Be clean.
Start again.
Without electricity.
Yeah, he just needs a little
bit.
He's good. He's really good. He's a nice dog.
He's running through his legs.
You want a live ring or not?
No, dead ring. I just want to look at his temperament and stuff so I know what I'm doing.
No, 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 no.
Between your legs, kind of.
Ah!
All right. Unhook your collar. Off lead. Fire him up. Send him now. Stay back. Stay back. Send him for a bite. Pocket. Now stay back. Stay back.
Raise your dog.
Sorta brav, yes, good.
Peel him off. We're gonna do one more. Send him.
Ready.
Take him out. I gotta do it on leave.
gotta teach him who to bite.
Come back here, I'm gonna send a dog.
Stand here so he has to come up. Just go stand him over here so he can see what way to come up. Okay? Hold on. Praise your dog. Tell him he's a good dog.
Something?
Yeah.
Remember how Armin used to teach the out so the dog barked afterwards and was stimulated? And a collar? You know, 8, 10, 12 times as fast as you possibly can in a row? Teach him that.
He did the out with multiple pops in a row. As soon as he's out, we return to agitation. What I want to happen is the out to be motivational. I want him to stimulate him into his fight drives.
Okay.
Okay. So try to copy that the best you can. Let him know if biting is correct.
Okay.
Tell him he's a wonderful cocker for this. And then I'll signal you with my eyes.
Okay.
As to what I want you to do. All right? And as soon as his mouth comes open, you can stop pulling him back to him.
Okay.
Timing on your part.
Okay. Check that out. We're gonna send him for a bark.
Well, you come over here.
Send him now.
Ready here?
Like this. You've got a job.
That's right.
Your job is to keep that man from getting hurt. And it's
it's more than just that, because the dog's not doing this because he wants to hurt his handler. He's doing this out of reflexive work. You're going to have to change that reflex back onto you. That means you have to put a little bit onto the dog as soon as he's out when you're doing this kind of work. And you saw what happened. I refocused this dog onto me. It's important you guys as decoys see this kind of stuff and see that timing on your part makes the training good. Because if it starts to get to where every time this dog comes off and bites him, your training all goes to hell. It all gets bad. So as a decoy, it's something to learn.
Same thing happened when I did it. When somebody else handles like I handled your dog, and he turned, Kevin Bryant right there. Such a higher drive level, he's just biting me harder than he normally does.
Fire him up for
a fine and bark or a bite?
Just a bite.
Fuck off. Fucking. Oh, boy.
That's a T-1000. And he's young.
He's not going to out for you. Right now. Nope. So peel him up. Let's not have a mistake. Put him up.
I think the dog's too much for you to handle. I think you sent it for warning.
give your announcement and then send it.
Sheriff's Department! Come on, or we'll send in the dog! Sheriff's Department! Come on, or we'll send in the dog!
Now.
have the experience in those behaviors. Because you get caught in that trap, and if you can't do something about it while you're caught in it, you got a problem that's going to exist for a long, long time or forever. So we prevented that from happening. And you saw that when he only had two options, he had the option of self-defense and he had the option of prey. And I'd put the pressure from the self-defense on him and channel it into the prey drive. He got better, and he got better. For those guys who saw him yesterday, he's improved a whole lot. And so we'll keep building on that while I'm here. Now, it's hard to do with a suit on. It's better to do with a sleeve. Your timing can be better because the dog has to enter self-defense and enter prey drive very quickly. The events have to happen close in time. They can't be subsequent events. They have to be very close together so the dog sees it as one event. Defending myself, prey. Defending myself, prey. And we have to keep him on this end of that, the prey side of that. Look at prey over here on the right, avoidance over on the left, a flight type of avoidance on the left, and your self-defense drives over here. We're trying to stay over.
Okay, Flaxen. Let's. With this dog, you should always start out of the flat. Let's. Okay, rear for run for you.
Run.
Side of the head, underneath the chin, and occasionally other parts. If the dog is a real hard case, if you come down and you point your hand at his butt, you can hit the top of the head without hurting the eyes. And if this is, I like doing this to Ed. If this is the top of, up a little bit, right there, look up, look at the dog. All right, if you come over the top of the head and you're pointing at his butt, which is lower than his head, you can hit the dog over the top of the head without creating a damage to the dog. If you hit the dog like this, or you hit the dog at all from the side, you're gonna strike the eyes. So you have to try to point the stick at his butt when you do it. And if you do it any other way, you're gonna have a problem at some point in time. Also, if you don't whack and come back,
Well, I can come back. If you continue to stroke through, then you slide across the eye. So it's a poof, and it's over.
And it's done. But it's something you have to practice. Go out in your backyard and hit leaves until you're really good at it.
I didn't get the real intensity of that because you actually do it.
Okay. For a box. Okay, who's next?
Give me your announcement and send the dog.
There, Spider, come on out and send the dog. Come on out, send the dog.
I said you had a creeping problem. We'll show you a little technique that can help. Not always, but it can help. Flat your dog. Stand up. All right. Come walk towards me like you're going to do a little pat down. Halfway to me. Flat.
Flat!
Okay. More pronounced. Come stepping towards me with some commitment. And then flat.
Flat!
Now come out. Hands up.
Hands up. Flat!
Again, this is a dog I kind of know the history on. And you saw the dog start to push. Step on that chin. I was standing there, and the dog started to push, and you saw him going. And you know that what he's thinking after what happened yesterday, he pushed and pushed and pushed and then got dirty. As he came in and he pushed, and he started pushing, and he started pushing. So I let him push a little bit more and gave him a small correction. And then when the dog settled back down, gave me a little space, sat his ass on the ground, then he received his reward. There's a lot of components to the bark and hold. It's not just barking. On a dog that's strong like this dog, this is a very nice dog. A dog that's strong like this, you've got to be a little concerned about some of the finer details.
Like, he only gets a reward when he puts his ass on the ground and stays out of your face. Some dogs will put a little pressure and make him do a Plotzen bark, if that's what it takes to make this dog clean. What's important is that they have a complete understanding of what they need to do. And some of the dogs that work in real high drive, like this dog, need to have a very strict set of training rules. Very strict. He either has to, now another dog might be standing. I mean, every dog's an individual. I'm not saying teach all your dogs to sit on their ass to get a bite. I'm not saying that. I'm saying you have to tailor the training for each individual dog. This one needs to put his butt on the ground and stay out of your face. Otherwise, he's going to get to be a problem.
Kevin, what about, he's conditioned that he likes to come in and do his bark mold right in your face.
Yeah.
Because of probably the sport work. Is that what you foresee that from, or is it just
he's confident? No, that's the dog's temperament.
He just likes that.
Yeah.
What about working him back out of that for a...
And I think it's appropriate for a police dog to be, you know, out a little ways. But on a dog that it was a difficult thing to get a bark and hold, I'll accept this over nothing. And
it's living proof. But a dog can bite that doesn't have teeth.
Can't say that the zeb though, I'm looking at my fancy chrome teeth and it's sticking out.
Watch what you say, it's going on.
I like the way that dog's sitting. Out a little ways. Barking continuously. Not a problem with the dog. The bark and hold is real clean, real easy. Not a problem to maintain. A big steady dog. He does have a problem with letting go. So we're going to work on the out to flats a little bit later. Pet your dog.
tell him how good he is. Titled dog, untitled dog?
Titled, check one.
Okay. Next one.
Oh! Jim Allen while laying on their head.
Off, Ligon. Off. Loans. Loans. Off. Loans. Loans.
Want to do a leg and off of this?
Yep. Okay. Stand still. Los off leg. Good. Right.
Okay, let's go to the wall.
Dragging or loose?
Let him drag.
Off. Off leg. We have this one is the one to drag?
No, you're on.
The one around your waist.
Oh, just a short one.
Okay, take him off.
Out!
I use the same importers.
Sleeve out.
Okay, back away from your dog. Get him off the equipment. Quickly, get him. Okay. Long line on the dog. Let him drag it. Let's see if you've got the dog.
Jeff. Yeah.
Step back from the dog.
Step back from the dog. Leg it.
Step up to your dog.
Stand still.
Okay, I'm dragging along line. Set it.
Drag it along.
Yeah, keep him legging.
Legging.
Try to make a mistake.
Nine. Legging.
This moose makes a mistake and walk all over.
Moose. Legging.
What a mess now. Whoa.
Here. All right, with Andor.
Nine.
Legging.
Legging.
All right, with Andor, you start electricity when he gets there. Send him.
naked. Sheriff's Department, stop, I'll see my dog! Sheriff's Department, stop, I'll see my dog! Sit, give loud.
Number 15 on that?
That's two! Put your hands up in the air! Leg it!
Around the corner. I could see. You know, okay? And we're going to keep doing that sort of thing until he anticipates it, does it correctly, and he will receive an immediate reward in the bite for that. Immediately. The problem I see with people using electricity. Ligon! Ligon! Damn it, it didn't work. Ligon! Okay. No, it's Ligon. And then the next time it's Ligon and he goes plop. Good dog. The dog has to anticipate the possibility of that correction and be correct for that and avoid receiving the electricity. Or eventually he's going to power through. And that's the biggest problem I see with police dogs and electricity. I use a Tritronics with a little bit of a different setup, and I like it a lot better than this. The Tritronics. 200? Yeah, 200 with the short durations and the panic button.
It worked. Yeah, I really like that.
It's worked real well for me. Which it only has one intensity. You don't have levels. It only has one intensity, but you have a real decreased durations on it. And I like it a lot. It works real well for me.
Another Cito.
Huh? Who's next?
Another Cito.
Yeah. What
do you think, Kevin? Background.
Bring him to the other one.
Pallads.
Does he have a title?
No.
Okay.
He saw his European dog training, and the dog is trying real hard to stay focused on the man, and he's being asked to return to heel. And it's hard on these dogs to do that. It's hard to take them out of what they understand. I personally don't do this kind of a recall. my personal thing is I'll do a clutch, and if I need to recall my dog out of the clutch, I'll recall him out of the clutch. And I play with this quite a bit. I personally don't agree with it. Nor do most people working in the German system. And that's not meant to say that Tom's wrong. I mean, Tom and I worked together for a lot of years.
It's just that that's the direction he's wanted to go. For one reason or another, he's finding it works better for him.
Well, we can work towards something else.
I think he should be flashed off the bike. Okay, bring him to the end. Get your hands out of your pocket.
Palats! Palats! That's a boy, yeah! Palats!
Tell me, step back from the dog, Palats.
Step back from my dog, Palats! Palats! Step back from the dog! Palats!
Okay, go ahead and reinforce your command. Palats!
Palats!
Okay. Good. Just stay next to your dog and pet him.
See how quickly this dog came back into what he understands?
I don't like dogs.
Lots. Lots.
Okay. Let's see what he knows about the circle of bark.
Run.
They never got to the point where they got him around their back without having to turn with the dog. We'll work on it.
Okay, peel them off.
House. House.
Dog's killed. And handler's killed. Border Patrol officers were being killed all the time by smugglers. They looked at the dog and said, we gotta do something. And what their solution to the problem was to teach the dog never to stop moving, to teach him that if the man stops moving, you circle him, you bark at him. That if you engage the man, you disengage the man once he stops moving, and go back to your circling and barking. The reason for this was that smugglers were getting smart and giving dogs bites and knifing them. Their favorite toy was a plank with a handle on the end and a big metal spike in the other, and they go, plop! Stick the spike into the dog's head. This was the development of the circle and bark. We gotta save the dogs, we gotta save the handlers. Because the next thing that happened is the handler's following his quiet dog, didn't know where his dog was at, and he had to deal with the smuggler. And they were killing Border Patrol officers there. So this was the solution. The circle and bark, when done completely, has a man standing still, has the dog doing a circle and going around behind his back. Whereas right now, this dog's at a point where I'm having to help him come around. It's born out of a lot of defense and a lot of avoidance to the stick. And again, you gotta think about why they did this. Save dogs, save officers. Get the dog to continue to sound off. Even if you only got a few barks before the dog was dead, it was better to know that something was going on out there. So that's the origination of it. When seen in a real nice dog done really nice, really well, I don't get a lot of experience doing this anymore. We don't get to do it that much. I think it's a neat technique. I wish I had a decoy that could do it on mine. Because it's a real functional technique. Now, when you're working a circle and bark dog, your control is a Palats out of that circle. It's got to be a Palats out of that circle. And what the problem that people tend to have when they're dealing with a dog like this is they tend to start chasing the dog around the circle. All you have to do is wait till he comes around and blast the dog. Something else I saw a lot of people doing that you could solve a lot of your problems is they start chasing their dog on the decoy. Go around in circles on the decoy. Just
come within about 5 or 10 feet, stop. The decoy should be trained to bring the dog to you.
This will solve all that problem of the dog running away from you. If you know your dog is going to go that way, just cut him off. Real important. It sounds like a little minuscule thing.
Bring him out to the end so he doesn't get tangled.
Police officer, stop him!